Director, Mr. Irupa Shankar and Mr. Amar Mehsul, Executive Director, and Mr. Atul Goyal, CFO, Management of Brigade Enterprises. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. M.R. Jaishankar, Chairman and Managing Director. Thank you, and over to you, Mr. Jaishankar.
Thank you. Thank you everyone for joining, and good afternoon. We hope all of you and your loved ones are keeping well in these tough times. On behalf of the company, I would like to welcome you on the earnings call for the fourth quarter of financial year 2021. I am joined remotely by our Executive Director, Ms. Nirupa Shankar, Mr. Amar Mehsul. Our senior management team is also present on the call. Mr. Atul Goyal, Mr. Rajendra Joshi, CEO Residential, Mr. Vineet Verma, CEO Hospitality, Mr. Subrata Sharma, CEO Office, Mr. Om Prakash, Company Secretary, and Mr. Pradyumna Krishna Kumar, Vice President, Investor Relations. Due to the current lockdown in Bangalore, people are connected to this call remotely from different locations. So if there is any kind of issue during the answer, kindly bear with us. We in Bangalore are currently under lockdown as the healthcare system is working hard to cope with the second wave of the Wuhan virus. Citizens of this country continue to struggle to find beds and oxygen, and we must do our part to break the chain by remaining at home despite the cost to business. FY21 was a disruptive year that required us to be agile and change the way we do business. Despite a muted Q1, we are happy to report our company recorded its highest ever yearly sales of 4.6 billion square feet in a residential segment, resulting in a sale of ₹2,767 crores, a 16% increase over the previous year. This was mainly contributed by the residential business that registered another record-breaking performance in Q4. We clocked over 1.66 million square feet of new bookings in a quarter for the first time, having a value of 1,018 crores. We have also had our best quarter on the collections front at ₹840 crores in Q4, a growth of 58% from the previous quarter, driven by high sales and good construction progress. The key reason for our continued success is a result of our core business proposition, that is, having the right projects in the right location at the right prices, our quality and service that customers associate with Brand Brigade, in addition to our innovative marketing campaigns and the high quality of our sales team. Our projects in Hyderabad and Chennai continue to deliver consistently high results, along with our projects in Bangalore. The key trends observed in Q3 have continued in Q4. That is, customers continue their preference for completed inventory and larger units. There is high demand for homes priced between ₹50 lakhs to ₹1 crore, and larger players have shown high growth, further consolidating the market. The outlook for Q1 FY22, that is in the coming financial year, is again muted due to the resurgence of COVID-19 second wave. However, we believe that the rebound for the market during financial year 22 will mirror what we witnessed in FY21, as long as we are not affected by the so-called third wave of the virus. In our office segment, the continued focus on collection of lease rentals has resulted in 99% collections. On the leasing front, while we were experiencing increased momentum in inquiries, RFP releases, which is request for proposal releases, and site inspections, the market has gone into hibernation mode since the onset of COVID second wave. However, robust hiring in IT and ITS sectors is creating quite a good amount of latent demand for real estate spaces. This sentiment is well exhibited among all of our ongoing discussions with prospective clients and also among our major new tenants who are poised to start their operations in Chennai and Bangalore. As on date, our high probability pipeline is around 1 million square feet in Brigade Tech Garden, Bangalore, and World Trade Center, Chennai, and BIFC, that is Brigade International Financial Center, in GIFT City, Gujarat. The pipeline constitutes large, medium, and small-sized inquiries. Inquiries and transaction momentum at the GIFT City has increased significantly with the additions of multiple asset classes under IFSC, at the International Finance Service Center. We have concluded lease renewals of approximately 200,000 square feet this quarter and concluded lease agreements for Brigade Southfield, a 345,000 square feet building in Whitefield, Bangalore, and Brigade Senate, a 177,000 square feet building previously strata sold to investors. These have been taken up by Fortune 500 companies. Coming to the retail vertical, it saw better than expected recovery trend, with sales for many stores reaching 90% of pre-COVID levels by March 2021, primarily in our flagship mall, Orion Gateway. Rent recovery was at 96% for the quarter compared to Q4 of FY20. Categories that did well were consumer, electronics, cosmetics, sports, and athleisure, fast fashion department stores. In our flagship mall, Orion at Brigade Gateway, the good news is that 17 new leases were concluded, accounting for 7% of the gross leasable area, with an average increase of 10% in the rentals. There were another 20 tenants who renewed their leases, with an average of 31% escalation in rentals, accounting for 5% of the gross leasable area compared to the previous lease deed term signed. Despite the current lockdown, our focus continues to be on proactive tenant engagement and rental recovery so that once stores are allowed to reopen, tenants are focused on operations and prepared for a bounce back. Finally, in our hospitality business, we continue to see positive improvements in Q4. Our portfolio of 8 hotels achieved an average occupancy of 43% in Q4 compared to 27% in Q3. However, average room rates continued to be under pressure, having reached close to 60% of pre-COVID levels. Gross operating profits for the portfolio increased from 16% in the previous quarter to 22% for Q4 FY21. The hotels continued strict monitoring of operating costs and other overheads to ensure that we protect our bottom line as far as possible without compromising on the quality of our services. But with the recently added lockdown restrictions imposed in the cities we operate in, we expect the hospitality industry as a whole to be under pressure until there is relaxation on travel and movement of people. We continue to monitor the situation on a day-to-day basis. Based on the performance of Q4, we were extremely bullish for FY22 and set ourselves aggressive targets. But the lockdown and impact of the second wave has created a dampener for the Q1 of financial year 22. We remain hopeful that with the government's plan to get the entire adult population vaccinated in the coming year, the business environment will become more conducive for travel and transactions, and we can focus on sales and strategy. Thank you for your patience. Now, Mr. Atul Goyal, our CFO, will present the financial results in detail. Thank you, Anthony.
Thank you, sir. Thank you and good afternoon, everybody. I think everybody and your loved ones are safe. On behalf of the company, I would like to welcome you on the earnings call for Q4 FY 2021. In Q4 and last, it was almost open and showed a sign of all-round recovery. It led to an increase in pace of recovery in real estate, especially new launches and sales across our key market witnessed a significant jump. Similar to last quarter, sales picked up due to all-time low home loan rates, stagnant residential prices, work from home. The consolidation in the sector has also played a big role. The easing of lockdown restrictions further aided in bringing buyers back to the market as sites which were easier to plan. On company side, this quarter again has been better than last quarter in terms of business performance. Let me give you some key highlights. CMD has already shared. We have recorded all-time high sales of 1.66 million square feet during this quarter, vis-a-vis 1.53 million square feet during last quarter. For FY21, the sales volume stood at 4.6 million with a total value of 2767 crores, recording a growth of 16% over previous financial year, and is also highest ever sales by the company. As demonstrated in our investor presentation, our real estate has been growing at a CAGR of 43% over the last 3 years. As of 31st March 21, Brigade had expressed had approximately 18 million square feet of ongoing project and 1.43 million of upcoming project, and we are confident to maintain this run rate in future as well. We have also seen significant jump in residential collections, and this was the best quarter in terms of collection totaling to 840 crores in Q4. Total collections were also highest in Q4 at 1,118 crores, 64% higher than last quarter. Incidentally, this is the highest collection which company has done in its history. On the leasing side, we have been achieving 99% rental collection with gradual increase in reoccupancy in the operational portfolio. On the retail side, we have witnessed higher tenant occupancy, and in the mall, consumption was about 90% of pre-COVID levels. We also saw a decent uptick in hospitality performance of September 2020. We have broken even in terms of operation in whole hotels with average portfolio occupancy increasing to 43% in Q4 FY21 from 27% in Q3 FY21. GOP margin stood at 22% for the quarter. Company is confident of mitigating the impact of the second lockdown by strict monitoring of cost and plugging the deficit, if any, in hospitality further. On a consolidation level, there was an increase in operational cash flow from operating activities by 61% from last quarter and 83% from last year. We continue to have adequate liquidity and undrawn credit lines from the bank. Our average cost of debt has been lowest. It has been coming down consistently over the past few quarters and was 8.40% as on March 21 versus 9.57 as on March 20. A 117 bits reduction that would result in an annualized saving of over 50 crores. Coming to consolidated financial performance for FY21, the consolidated revenue for FY21 stood at 2010 crores versus 2680 crores for FY20, whereas the same for Q4 FY21 stood at 821 crores versus 654 crores in the previous quarter, up 26%. The consolidated EBITDA for FY21 stood at 532 crores. EBITDA margin stood at 26%, which we have been maintaining for so many years. The EBITDA for Q4 FY21 was 218 crores versus 137 crores in previous quarter, up 39%. The real estate segment clocked a turnover of 1525 crores at an EBITDA of 17%. The hospitality segment clocked 13 crores and an EBITDA of 5%. The leasing segment clocked a turnover of 371 crores at an EBITDA of 70% in FY21. The interest and finance charges for FY21 stood at 346 crores. Consolidated PAT after MI for FY 21 stand at minus 46 crores. Coming to the debt position, there was a reduction of 200 crores in real estate debt, which is driven by higher sales and collection. The cash and cash equivalent stand at 723 crores as on March 31st, which is one of the highest company has had. Company's net debt outstanding as on March 31st, 2021, is 3574 crores, out of which BL share is 2654 crores. 75% of the total debt pertains to commercial portion, of which 65% is backed by the rental income. We have credit rating of A with stable outlook, which has been assigned by both CRISIL and ICRA. Now I'll hand it back to the moderator for questions. Thanks.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Abhidev Chattopadhyay from ICICI Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks for the opportunity. Good afternoon, everyone. The first question is on the residential business. Could you just quantify for this quarter the percentage breakup of sales between Bangalore, Hyderabad and Chennai, if that is available?
Our CEO, Joshi, will respond.
Yeah.
So, good afternoon, everyone. For the Q4, we had nearly 60% of our sales coming from Bangalore and the balance 40 coming between Chennai and Hyderabad.
Okay. Okay. And Chennai would be the WTC residences, right? That is the only project, or the Xanadu is also?
We have two projects, Xanadu in West Magadhar and WTC residences. So both these put together, the volume and value really came from Xanadu. Xanadu saw a very good uptick in Q3 and Q4.
Okay. Okay. And follow-up question is that since you've done such a good performance even in, under COVID in FY21, so any range of guidance for the residential business which you're targeting for next year?
As you know, we normally don't give any guidance numbers, but first quarter will definitely be muted, as Mr. Jayashankar pointed out, because of lockdown in all three cities that we majorly operate in. We do expect that from Q2 onwards, business will pick up.
Okay, okay, okay. Fine, fine. Thank you. And second question is on our mall business. So Mr. Jayashankar alluded that we have signed up new leases and also you have done rental renewals. So with the again the lockdown again happening with malls being shut, now could you give us a color on what is the sort of rental waivers or anything that we may have to give, or is it too early to take a call there?
Yeah, hi Aditi, Nirupa here. See, basically we followed a fairly fair pattern last lockdown, where we basically, based on the different kind of categories, obviously for cinemas it was different, food and beverage it was different, anchors was different, vanilla stores was different. But basically from most of the stores, especially the apparel stores, we were able to get some sort of maybe like between 50% to 25% of the minimum guaranteed rental. And what we did is we had a structure, also like a slab structure for once the lockdown is over, we had a slab structure for that as well. So for instance, suppose the retailers did about 80% to 100% of their pre-COVID level sales, then we would charge them say 75% of the MG. If it was between maybe 50 to 80%, it was say 50% of the MG. So we had different slabs for various categories. And we had come up with an agreement where all of us, where the tenant and us signed off on that agreement last lockdown period and post-lockdown period. So what we are doing is we have proactively reached out to all the tenants this lockdown and said that we plan to follow a similar structure as last time so that we don't have to reinvent the wheel and waste time and effort on renegotiation. So our communication has gone out to most of them already, and we hope to sort of decide on the commercials during the lockdown period so that once we open, everybody already knows what their dues are and we can just focus on business.
Okay, sure. And just a housekeeping question for last FY21, for the mall business, what is the rent we would have lost, or rather how much would you have collected of the had the lockdown not been there?
Oh, so actually for FY20, it was approximately 120 odd crores. And we did about 50% of that in FY21. Had the lockdown not been there, then it would have been much more, obviously, because we look on annual growth. But we did about 50% of the previous year.
Okay. Fine. Fine, that's helpful. I'll come back in the queue with more questions. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, in order to ensure that the management is able to address questions from all participants, please limit your questions to 2 per participant. If you have a follow-up question, you may rejoin the queue. The next question is from the line of Ritesh Sheth from Edelweiss Wealth. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Thanks for the opportunity. Congrats on the great year despite the COVID. My first question is on, firstly, you had a good launches this quarter, 3 million square feet odd. So how much did that contribute to our overall sales?
Joshi?
So the new launches for the last quarter contributed about 30% of the total sales by value.
Okay, fine. And looking at your pipeline for FY22, it looks, obviously, there's an uncertainty around, but it looks a tad low. So where can the pipeline go if, let's say, things recover from Q2 onwards?
So if I understand your question correctly, you are asking where will the pipeline go? Or where?
Yeah, residential pipeline in terms of launches expected for FY22.
Yeah. So currently what we've indicated is where we have a visibility on approval. There are some more projects which are in the pipeline, which we intend to launch as and when we get approvals, and also based on market sentiment. For the year FY22, we have a fairly good pipeline.
Okay, so can we expect like the launch pipeline to continue to be around 5-6 million square feet that you have reported over the last 3 years?
It will essentially, what we clearly see is that there is an inherent demand which is there this time. The second feedback from the ground is that the customers are a lot more confident this time compared to last time, because last time it was the first time that we had such a kind of pandemic, and the customers were very unsure of their income streams, etc., which doesn't seem to be, uncertainty is much lower. But one has to wait and see how the pandemic will play out, simply because this time it is a lot more lethal and a lot more contagious compared to last time.
Okay. And just lastly, just on the follow-up, so Granado 4, you had one minimal launch this quarter, but I don't see in the pipeline from here on, in the FY22 pipeline which you indicated. So any change of plans there? I mean, Granado is ideally doing good, so...
Yes, so with this one last cluster or phase that we are yet to launch, we are in the process of launch, so that will get into action once the lockdown opens.
Okay, fine. Thanks. I think I'll join back the queue. I have no questions. Thank you. All the best.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Yash Gupta from Angel Broking. Please go ahead.
Thank you for the opportunity, sir. Can you throw some light on how the construction activities are going on our various projects, and as well as how customer inquiries, whether it's online or offline?
Yeah. See, as far as the construction activity is concerned, they were all progressing quite robustly.
And we have about 11,000, nearly 11,000 workmen in various sites. Only during the lockdown, I think there has been a gradual decline so far. But in spite of that, we have about 70% of the workmen working in our different sites. And I think once the lockdown is lifted, within a few weeks, the numbers will come back to the previous level, and it may even go up. And as far as the business scenario is concerned, I think Joshi can add about our efforts on digital marketing and others.
Yeah, thank you, sir. So as far as the transactions and inquiries are concerned, they have been online. In fact, digital has been the main source of our inquiries for the last 3 years. But because of the lockdown in the last 2 to 3 weeks, a lot of transactions, whatever that is happening, has been online transactions, because we are not operating our sales offices in most of the cities.
Okay, thank you. Second question on the commercial office side. Can you share some detail on how the demand is there in the market? And along with that, if any detail you can share on the latest deal we have done on the commercial office side?
Yes. Mr. Subrata Sharma, our office head, will respond to this.
Yeah, thank you, sir. So as far as commercial segment is concerned, see, we feel that there is a significant amount of latent demand because of the robust hiring that is going on in IT/ITS sector. Plus, the sector is also growing, though not as vigorously as it was doing earlier, but there is a significant growth. Now, we also experienced the same, because when we started this quarter, we actually concluded 5 transactions, and we were actually hoping to do more, but because of this lockdown, again, everything became muted. So overall, we feel that based upon our pipeline, current pipeline of 1 million square feet and the kind of inquiries that we are getting, even today we got an RFP. So there is a kind of significant latent demand. We are just waiting for the things to normalize. So unless and until the reoccupancies start happening, we don't feel that real estate discussions will happen in the company. So though as per the strategic orientations, almost all the companies who actually want to expand or take up spaces, internal discussions are on.
So how different this particular deals are from the pre-COVID levels? I think in the first quarter, you have done a deal with the Teva Pharma. So how that particular deal is different from the pre-COVID deals that we used to do? Is that MTM is pretty much larger on this type of deal, what we are doing currently?
Basically, what is happening, is if you ask me, based upon our experience, whenever the deal size is huge, then companies would actually take more time to understand how the market phases the plans up, so that they can plan their manpower resources movement or deployment of their capex, etc. But so far that we are seeing, the gaining momentum is majorly from the mid-size and so far like 1 lakh to 2 lakh square feet of transactions, wherein companies want to actually gain the cost advantage. And we have seen quite a significant momentum in our BIFC in GIFT City, because of the various asset classes getting included under IFSC. So we saw almost like 4 transactions getting closed there. And we have done a sizable deal in terms of like BIFC size. Then we also saw quite a good number of inquiries in terms of mid-sized companies asking for spaces in our Brigade Tech Gardens and also in Chennai. So the momentum is majorly as on date from the mid-size and so-called 1 lakh to 2 lakh bracket. But at the same time, we are in discussion for very large size transactions, but that we feel will take time.
Okay. Great. Thank you. Congrats on a good set of numbers.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Parikshit Kandapal from HDFC Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Hi, Amar. Congratulations on a great quarter in terms of sales. So my first question is, the last 2 quarters, we have done 1 million and 1.5 million now. So if I annualize it, maybe we'll be ballpark somewhere about 4 million to 6 million annually. So, and if I look to your overall pipeline, so we have about 7 million of unsold launch projects and about 30 million of feet of land bank. So from the business development perspective, so we have about 5 to 6 years of land bank. My first question is, out of this 27 million, how much can be brought into the market, or it is ready to be launched in market if we bring it? And second would be again on business development. So this will call for sustained investment in land bank over the next few years to build the land pipeline. If you can just highlight your business development efforts, both on land acquisition, JD, JV opportunities, in context of kind of volumes which you are doing right now.
Good afternoon. While as earlier mentioned, we may not want to give the guidance, but it is the desire of every company to do the better year after year. That is our objective also. As I said, as far as Q1 is concerned, since it is muted, we will not be in a position to estimate for the rest of the year till the things improve. But we hope things will settle down in the coming month itself. And having said that, the other than the 1.43 million, which is with approvals that are ready to be launched, we have nearly 2 million square feet more. That is we should be able to get the approvals fairly soon or within the next 2 quarters, and be able to launch that. And of the 5 to 6 years, stock that we have, these are all very, very doable, and they are also in a different stages of design development, and also the it depends on the various permissions. Considering some of them are large projects, so it may take a little bit longer in order to get the environmental clearances and the related thing. But I think we are at it. And naturally, acquiring more properties is an ongoing process. That exercise is always on.
So last year we invested close to 185 crores in land. So do you think this would be sustained on an annual basis for next few years, about 200 crores investment in land?
Probably yes, but it all depends whether we end up signing joint development agreements, or we end up signing properties to purchase. It depends on that. But I think that kind of a estimate is not wrong. We have to keep that in mind.
Okay. So my next question is on the commercial business now. So you said that we had done about 5.
We can't hear you very clearly. May I repeat?
Okay, sir. Just 1 second.
Yeah, sir. Is it better now? Hello?
Yeah.
So the second question was on the commercial leasing business. So now we had seen a good, a decent start for the fourth quarter, and 5 transactions were concluded. So just wanted to know what is the total quantum of these transactions and which project. And second thing would be on BTG. So there, what kind of RFPs we are seeing for BTG project, and when do we see really the leasing start kicking up there? From which quarter, maybe this financial year, where do we start hearing some positive developments in that project?
So Subrata Sharma will respond to this.
So as far as the recent transactions are concerned, so as I said, these are like mostly small and medium-sized companies that we concluded. So overall, it would be somewhere around 0.1 million. But having said that, we have high probability pipeline. We also intend to actually be focusing on another about 0.25 million of transaction in this quarter. In fact, that was the outlook like before this lockdown. Having said that, majority of the pipeline that we have, out of like 1 million pipeline, almost 75% of it actually pertains to Brigade Tech Gardens. And as I was mentioning just a while ago, that the RFP that we received, that is also focused on the same micro market. So going forward, we feel that there will be like quite a good amount of inquiries of Brigade Tech Garden, mainly because of its strategic location. And it being an SEZ and also outer ring road near that micro market, having very less vacancy, there would a lot of expansion, consolidation that will actually be sought after like by companies, and they will find BTG as a very good value proposition. So that's why we are quite confident of the marketability of the property going forward.
So when do we see one of the bigger ones of these deals materializing in by which third quarter of this year? Third quarter of financial year of like October.
So far as the bigger deals are concerned, no, companies will, I mean, they will certainly take more time to actually think on the strategic expansion route, how they actually plan their capex, etc. So that certainly will take time, and we feel that once that actually normalizes, around 3 months from the that phase, I think these companies will actually start acting on those. So we have, like, see, to give you an example, like, we have few transactions. Those are a kind of 1 lakh square feet in the range. They have been discussing with us for the past 1 year, okay? And because of most of the IT companies are actually gone, they have actually accelerated hiring. Okay? So they want their manpower to come back. So these discussions are happening, and we feel that as soon as it normalizes within 3 months, I think these companies will start taking decisions.
Okay.
So as you rightly said, 2 quarters from now, I think that would be a fair estimate.
Okay. Just lastly on the pre-sales, sir, this quarter you said will be muted. So muted, like, it could be 50% off or less than 50%. So it's 50 to 100% in that range or less than 50% of the fourth quarter's number?
Joshi.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. So very difficult to estimate at this point in time, because we still don't have clarity as to when the lockdowns will get lifted, etc. If the lockdown gets lifted, we should see a better June, but it will be very difficult to estimate a percentage at this point in time.
Okay, sir. Thank you. That's all from my side. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Amandeep Singh from Ambit Capital. Please go ahead.
Thanks for the opportunity. So you did mention about construction being impacted given labor issues and lockdown restrictions, especially in Bangalore. But will it be possible to quantify how much delay would you expect in terms of ongoing construction across your portfolio?
At this point of time, if you ask me, the lockdown is lifted by end of the month or earlier. It may mean, 4 to 6 weeks like that. It may mean like that, or maybe sometimes even 8 weeks, because the labor has to come back. I think only when lockdown is lifted, we will be in a position to assess it. Last time, in the lockdown, when it was almost, it was a very strict national lockdown, and with a lot of migrant labor went back with a lot of difficulties, encountering a lot of difficulties. So for that to revive, it took almost 4 to 5 months time in terms of activity revival. But this time, I don't think it is going to happen like that, primarily because it is not a total lockdown unlike last time. Construction activity is still allowed. But, maybe the extent of activity is, as I said, it is down by 30-35%. We will be able to estimate once work resumes.
Sure, sir. Thanks for it. And sir, secondly, with respect to your commercial portfolio, will it be fair to assume that increased area of Brigade Tech Gardens and recently added WTC Chennai would start yielding rentals 1QFY22 onwards? And consequently, what should be the exit annualized rentals at current occupancy for the entire leasing portfolio? Any
yeah.
Sense on that?
Subrata Sharma will answer more, but as far as Brigade Tech Garden, the first phase of 1 million square feet is yielding rent already. And as far as World Trade, the second phase should also start, some rent will start in Q2. And the same with World Trade Center Chennai. It will start beginning Q2, it will start. It's a graded approach is there. I think it will start from Q2.
Sure, sir. That's helpful. And sir, as a follow-up to this, so could you help us understand how much of your existing commercial portfolio would be up for renewal in FY22, and if you are expecting any exits?
Subrata, I think you can answer.
As far as our capability of retaining tenants, it has been like impeccable. Like last year also, we could actually retain the entire 100% of the tenants. And this year also, we have approximately 5 lakh square feet coming up for renewal. Out of that, 4.9 lakh is Sure. They are actually, we have already gone ahead with the discussion for the renewals and we are doing the formalities. 10,000 square feet is under discussion, but that also will get renewed for sure. So that's what, like, we have like visibility in terms of closing almost 100%.
Sure, sir. And will it be possible to give any sense on this 4.9 lakh renewals? What would be the escalation or releasing spread approximately?
So the escalation normally it's like 15% every year for most of the tenants. So if we take a 5-year actually renewal term, okay, like 5 or 10 years, so ultimately it would be somewhere around 10 to 15% on an average.
Sure, so that's very helpful. That's all from my side. Thank you and all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Vitlab Debaram from Antique Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. Hope all is well at your end. Sir, just wanted to understand on your excellent collections. What is the reason behind the jump in collection and what would be the breakup of that collection, like how much from residential, how much from others? This is my first question.
Yeah. Joshi and Atul can.
The collections are high is also because of the consistent sales which has been happening for last 4-5 quarters, and of course construction has been at good pace. So we have been able to raise demand, and based on that the collections have been coming. I think if you want breakup for Q4, as I said, 840 crores is from residential. Commercial sale is 61 crores. Commercial lease is 60 crores. Retail is 32 crores. Hospitality 96 crores. And maintenance side PMS is around 29 crores. So that adds up to 1,118 crores.
Okay. Thank you, sir. And the second question is on the rentals, office rentals. From the previous questions, I understand that not all the leased property started generating rent. So if we assume that there is no incremental leasing in the office space, whatever the leased area, if they become fully operational, what would be the total quarterly rent from this leased area in the office space?
Right now rental has not started, but next year I think we should be, since it will be a partial rental from WTC, and it depends upon retail as to how the retail rental
comes.
We should be we should touch around crores or so. This is if both the property get leased and retail get leased, we have a 750 crores of rental which will come maybe on 22-23 side.
No, sir. My question was, as it is, with whatever you have leased out, if all of them start generating income, what would be the rental income from the office only, on the office property?
So, Subrata can answer.
Yearly you are asking?
No, sir. Quarterly. Any one quarter. So whatever, without incremental leasing, whatever we have leased out and all of them started generating rentals, so what would be the total rentals from those office space in a particular quarter?
It should be in the range of 80 to 85 crores.
Okay, sir. Thank you. And one final question. Sir, in the negotiations or in renewals, or the renewals you have done, do you see any escalation in rentals? I mean, or is it like at the prevailing rate? Do you see significant escalations in rentals during renewal negotiations and all?
Yeah, so this is Subrata. So I'll take this question. So see, again, it depends upon the property and the micro market. Okay, in a property like our World Trade Center in Bangalore, wherein the vacancy is very less, okay, and it's a well-demanded, highly preferred property. Okay, in this case, like, we are at a better stance or position. So we will get the escalation, that is for sure. In certain other properties, there might be the negotiations that would be going on, but we still expect that on an average, we should get 10%. That is for sure, on a weighted average basis.
Okay, so you're expecting a escalation even in this
even in this scenario, why I'm actually telling this, because in all our properties, whatever the new leases that we have actually signed, in spite of dearth of a pipeline in the market, we have not gone below our rentals, weighted average rentals that we achieved. In fact, we have gone above, okay? So that's why we're thinking that we wouldn't actually go lower on the rentals, particularly for the renewals also.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you. I'll come back in the queue.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, request to please limit your question to 2 per participant. If you have a follow-up question, you may rejoin the queue. The next question is from the line of Parvez Akhtar Qazi from Edelweiss Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Good afternoon, gentlemen, and congratulations for a great set of numbers. Couple of questions from my side. First, just wanted to get your outlook on the realization side. Have we seen any kind of improvement as far as realizations are concerned on the residential side? The second is, what would have been the rental contribution from BTG this quarter? And lastly, when do we expect rent from the WTC Chennai to come in? Thanks.
Yeah, Joshi will answer the first part, and the second part, Subrata will answer.
Yeah, thank you. So in terms of price realization per square feet for FY21, we saw almost 11% jump. The increase was nearly about 400 to 500 rupees per square feet because of the new launches that we did in Hyderabad and Chennai. So overall, there has been a significant price increase that has happened in FY21 over FY20.
So with regards to the BTG rentals, so it was 18 crore per quarter. And as far as WTC Chennai rent commencement is concerned, it will start from Q2, means early Q2.
Sure. Thanks. That's it from my side, and all the best in future.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Swagata Ghosh from Franklin Templeton. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you, sir. So the follow-up on the realization question, like-to-like, were there any price hikes taken during December or March quarter?
Joshi?
Yeah. So on the price hikes, we did take some price hikes in our ongoing projects in Bangalore and in Chennai. We did see some price hikes. But what also contributed to the higher price was Hyderabad, where we did launch a project, and there also we took price hikes in the last 6 months that we've launched the project. Yes, there have been price hikes in the last 6 months.
Okay, and so this price hike was an exception versus history, or was it like in line with what we have done historically? I just want to understand the strength of the market in the last 6 months, and how do you expect the price hikes to pan out in the next, say, 2 years after the second wave is over?
Yeah. So the price hikes compared to the previous financial year were better in FY21 second half, once the situation was kind of getting back to normal. What we see, as Chairman had pointed out, there is a consolidation in the market, and therefore for larger developers like us in good locations, we are able to command a better price. That's what we said.
Okay. Okay, that's helpful. And second question is the Karnataka stamp duty cut, I guess that comes into effect from April. So how much of our inventory would be benefited from this cut, would be eligible for this cut?
Yeah, so I'll take this question again. So this was really for the affordable housing for up to 45 lakhs. So therefore, From our portfolio, only about 6 to 7% of the total would be within this price bracket. And most of that inventory, what we have, is also not getting registered. It's not ready for registration. So it will be very minimal impact on our set of properties.
Okay. So one last question, if I may. From a strategy perspective, if you are very confident of a residential upcycle, doesn't it make sense to be really aggressive on business development right now before the cycle actually kicks in?
I would, as I mentioned earlier, the business development is certainly an ongoing process. At any given point of time, currently itself, we are in the process of negotiating or having discussion of, for not less than 7 million square feet currently, and in the different locations. And some have come to an understanding, so the due diligence and etc. will be in progress. So it is, we are mindful of the fact. We will, we are at it.
Okay, got it. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Ritika Agarwal from ValueQuest. Please go ahead. Ms. Agarwal, please go ahead with the question. Your line is unmuted.
Hello. Sorry, I was on mute. Thank you for taking my question. First question is on, like you said, escalation pressures depend upon the micro market. So what percentage of your portfolio facing pressure on rentals or escalations?
I was not exactly, what was your question once again, please?
What I'm trying to understand is what percentage of our commercial portfolio we are witnessing pressure on rentals or escalations?
So, as of now, we are not experiencing any pressure as such. Okay? So, what I actually wanted to convey for the renewal call was, like, we are renewing everything and almost like 100%, and we haven't actually come across such a pressure in of rentals. So as of now, because of the strategic locations and the quality of the property, we have not experienced rental pressure. Means we have been able to actually go above the weighted average of the past transactions.
Okay, and we are in line with having escalations of around 5% every year on our existing commercial portfolio.
Normally it is 15% every year. In some of the cases, we have 5% per annum as well.
Okay, and we are in line with that. We are not seeing any pressures on that.
No, as of now, no. Though there will always be asks. Whenever you go for renewal, there will be asks. But because of our properties and the kind of occupancies that we have not actually, we haven't reduced the rental transaction.
Okay, and the renewals, which you said, is being happening at the current weighted average rate for the portfolio?
Renewals are happening as per the respective terms of the contract. Okay, so say a tenant X is having certain percentage of escalation and certain rentals they are actually currently on, so that same terms will actually continue for the renewals. Normally the terms wouldn't be changed.
Okay, understood. Secondly, on the hospitality portfolio, we were looking to divest part of it or completely. Any talks on that?
Not at the moment, because as we mentioned in the last call, whatever discussions we were having in FY20 because of the lockdown and COVID, that investor kind of decided not to go ahead with it. This year we have received, some requests to discuss, but then, it doesn't make sense at the kind of valuations that we're currently receiving. So we have the ability to kind of withstand this the second wave, because we are somehow managing paying back all our interest loans and things like that. So we will look at it, when there is an investor who is ready to give a decent valuation and you know, probably when the timing is more apt for this kind of a deal. Otherwise, we would not be keen to kind of divest in at a distressed time.
Sure. Lastly, what is our target for the debt reduction in the medium term?
See, we have already been reducing our debt continuously in residential. So I don't hope that any debt increase, major debt increase will happen in resi or hospitality. Hospitality, whatever increase is there on is on account of ECLGS loans. Of course, there will be increase in debt in commercial section where all the construction and when the leasing happens in Tech Garden and WTC, that will get converted into LRD in future. So the major chunk of debt increase will be in LRD, that is the conversion from construction loan to LRD.
Okay, thank you so much, sir, and all the best.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Prem Khurana from Anand Rathi. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you for taking my question, sir. So two questions. Of one was, I mean, is it possible to share, I mean, how has our market share changed in case of Bangalore, because I mean, as I see it, looks like the growth that we've seen during the year is essentially because, I mean, the Chennai as well as Hyderabad peers have done seriously good for, which is where, I mean, there's YOY growth. And I am assuming Bangalore otherwise would have been a little slow. So if you could share your thoughts on the market, the way the market share has changed for us during the year in Bangalore, and what number do you see is possible for any single player to be able to kind of go to, I mean, in terms of market share in any of these markets, especially Bangalore?
Joshi?
Yeah. So as you correctly pointed out, a lot of our growth for FY21 was driven by Chennai and Hyderabad. In Bangalore, in FY20, we had a substantial part contributed from Bangalore because we had two new launches, Eldorado, North Bangalore, and Utopia in East Bangalore. So therefore, the contribution of Bangalore did come down. But from a market perspective, I do see that Bangalore is quite vibrant because Bangalore also has moved up the chain. And therefore, the demand for larger units, more premium units, and from branded developers like us is continuing to increase. We do see increased demand for larger sized units, and I say larger sized units for the 3 BHK, the 3-bedroom units, etc. So I do not see so much of muting of demand in Bangalore. It is just that in what stage of the project life cycle we are there and we have new launches, etc. I think that would determine the traction from Bangalore, but otherwise, I do see traction from Bangalore to be continued.
Sure. Possible to share any number in terms of percentage? What is our market share today, and what are we targeting?
Market are difficult to estimate at this point in time because there is no one accurate agency, unlike in commercial space, there are accurate predictions. But we do think that in Bangalore, we are number two player in the residential space.
Sure. And the second was, so when I look at the balance sheet, it seems as though we're trying to conserve cash, right? I think, which is how you explain, I mean, the higher cash balance or the buffer that we've created. But at the same time, when I look at our launch pipeline, I get to see, I mean, over the last two quarters or rather three quarters, we've seen launch pipeline in terms of capex properties go up from 0.8 million square to 1.8. So how do I marry these two? I mean, essentially on one side, we're trying to conserve cash in hospitality as well as trying to generate more cash in resi. But on commercial side, we are willing to take up more capex properties, which is where you would have to spend money now.
Yeah, so we are not taking more capex property only now since WTC and Tech Gardens have got completed this time. So we have capitalized this. That's why in balance sheet you are looking at a higher investment property number. So it's mainly because of the capitalization of Tech Gardens and WTC, where not much capex is remaining to spend. Yeah, of course, now there is one big project, which is Twin Towers, and we have a sufficient financing lines to support that project going forward.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Abhijit Chattopadhyay from ICICI Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks for taking my follow-up question. Just see, now on our debt level thread, we brought it down almost our share by around 300 crores in a single quarter. So going forward for next couple of years, where do we see the debt levels overall headed for the company, considering that our residential cash flows are pretty strong and peak of our capex cycle is behind us, with Tech Gardens and WDC Chennai being completed?
So as I said, Abhidev, it will be mainly in LRD where the debt will remain, and it will get increased because we'll be converting the construction loans into LRD. So I don't see a major change. Maybe next year, because of the WTC, we may have around 300 crores of LRD again coming in, and of course, Tech Garden LRD will happen only if we are able to lease it in the right time.
Yes, sir. This is I understood, but and I'm saying the aggregate as a company for next couple of years. So considering our cash flows from Resi, and that we don't have to incur capex, so we should see our consolidated going down further, the net debt in aggregate, our share.
So see, our share, I think, if you see consolidated net debt, it should be around, it's around 2654 now, it should be around 1000 crores or so.
Sorry, sir, I lost that. I lost that amount.
Oh, so our exposure of BL right now is 2654 crores. It may go to around, if every LRD gets converted, it should be maximum by 3,100 crores.
Okay. Fine, sir. Okay, that's fine. Oh, yeah, thank you.
The next question is from the line of Ritesh from Edelweiss Wealth. Please go ahead. Mr. Chet, may we request you to please unmute yourself if needed from your handset?
Yeah, sorry. I was on mute. So, thanks for the follow-up. Just one clarification. We are not offering any discounts on the CAM income that we collect from the tenants for our commercial tenants, right?
There are two things. One is in the case of office tenants, there is no reduction in CAM because in every way, the properties are maintained, and because